the multi-species FLIRD, what are the benefits and what are the challenges, that kind of thing. So the benefits that come right out is that you've got more markets, you've got more diversity in that, but you also get more utilization of the pasture. Like, it was Idaho State, I believe, that said you could increase meat production by 24% by adding sheep to a cattle operation. So we're doing that. Then the parasite thing, sheep and goats share parasites, but cattle and sheep don't share significant parasites. So them running together, they're dead-end hosts for the other's parasites, so it helps the with parasite control. And parasites are worse with small ruminants than they are with cattle. The cattle serve somewhat as predator control. We also run some donkeys. I like to run one donkey per herd, but I've got two with them right now. And then we'll run some dogs with the flock and herd. And it takes more extensive fencing for sheep and a lot more for goats. And it's just more infrastructure needs with a sheep and cattle operation versus just cattle. Cattle, one wire, hot wire is good enough, and especially where it runs into labor for me, I don't mind it in the infrastructure for the main fields, but in the temporary fencing, you can get by with that one wire with cattle, and that's so much easier, and you can spread your post way out. With sheep, if you're going to run, well, I typically run three wires. I'm working on a strategy to run two and maybe even one wire, but it takes three wires right now with the posts spaced out about 40 feet. We've started using two wires and spacing the post about 20 feet, and we may go down to one wire and space the post as little as 15 or 12 feet and make the wire real tight, and that would be a daily rotation. So with the waters, I like the Rubbermaid 50-gallon tank and a Gallagher float, brass valve in it. The sheep can use the ball waters like the Ritchie and Mirafount that's for cattle. The lambs, of course, can't reach it. And if you're putting in a new one, you might want to think about putting in a step for the lambs to get up. The smaller ones to get up and get some water. I haven't worried too much about the watering. I use tire waters, and I've got them low for the sheep and goats to get to. I've lost some in the tire waters, so you need to have concrete block in there so that they can get on them and get out. The biggest problem I had was the water level in the tire water was too low, and they were reaching over too far and would fall in and didn't get out and drown. But in general, the cattle water works fine for the sheep.